Now we head to the lakeshore, where winds from the outreaches of Hurricane Sandy are already whipping up the waves on Lake Michigan. And Matt Kirkwood is out on the beach in Holland. What's it like out there right now, Matt?
It's quite windy. What Kyle just mentioned, the winds are going to be strongest right here, right along the lakeshore. Right now, I'm currently out at Holland. I'm already crunching on sand from the blowing sand out there here across on the beach. I want to point out a couple things out here. Right now, you can see the waves coming over the breakwater in the Holland area, and this is notorious. Whenever there's a north-northwest wind, you certainly don't want to be in the breakwaters in the Holland area. There's a few people out there, but they haven't gone all the way out to the end. They're still a little bit safe, but it goes without saying, don't go on any of the breakwaters or the piers anywhere along the lakeshore, because the waves are only going to get stronger. Something else I want to point out, if you look real closely into the horizon there where the clouds get a little lighter, that is the western fringe of the cirrus shield of the storm, which is now not even on shore yet in the eastern part of the United States and New Jersey. This gives you a scope of just how massive this storm is, and we're feeling the winds right now. Speaking of the winds, what kind of waves are they going to generate? Well, here's a map for you. Along the lakeshore, as these winds continue to intensify and likely peak on Tuesday, they're going to be anywhere between, I'd say, 14 to 16 feet. That's what the National Weather Service is estimating. But as you go out into central Lake Michigan, especially the south central part of Lake Michigan, we're going to see waves close to 30 feet peak. That's offshore Benton Harbor, Michigan City, and west, or actually east of Chicago. So it's absolutely massive. I call these kind of a 1%er days on Lake Michigan and the Great Lakes, where about 1% of the year you see the lake really churned up this much. So the good news is there's not many people, well, there isn't any people in boaters, not many boaters out there, obviously, this time of year. Obviously, stay out of the waters. Don't even go think about going on the breakwaters over the next 24 to actually 60 hours as this storm kind of intensifies in the eastern part of the United States. Back to you.